Hi, welcome to Whole Latte Love. My name is Mark Jackson. Today what I want to do is go over steaming. Steaming your milk is probably one of the hardest things to learn, to become really good at, and to do consistently. We're going to talk about something that's really kind of fun. It's called your W spot, and we're going to focus in on that. The W spot is actually where you get the milk to spin in the pitcher properly so that it gets the right amount of air aerated into the milk. And we're going to go over steaming both cappuccino and latte milk. Some of the important things that you want to keep in mind is, first, you need a great machine. The second thing is you want to have a bunch of good steaming pitchers. You need to have cold milk, which is really important. You might even want to put your steaming pitchers in the freezer. Some people will do that. Or you can put your steaming pitchers in the refrigerator. All those things really kind of help give you the right milk quality, right milk texture. So cold milk, cold pitchers. Some of the other things that you're going to want to have on hand, you're going to want to have a great thermometer. Before you steam your milk, one thing you always want to do is just go ahead and purge out your steam wand, because there's always going to be a little bit of water and milk in it, so you just go ahead. There we go. Got that out. Now we're ready to go. One of the key things about steaming milk with a thermometer is basically on most thermometers, or on the ones that we sell, there's going to be a red area where the target area is, which is going to be between about 140 and 160 degrees. So what I want to show you how to do is we're going to learn how to go ahead, steam the milk. We're not going to worry about technique right now. We're going to steam the milk, and I'm going to shut it off at a point where I know that it's going to stop in the red zone. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to get up to about 125, 130 degrees, right in that range, and then I'm going to go ahead and stop it. Perfect. Now, what I did is I stopped the thermometer at about 130 degrees, realizing that the temperature is still going to rise. It doesn't keep rising a lot of degrees, but you just have to be aware of it. I think that's one mistake people make with a thermometer is if you shut it off at 155, 160, what happens, your milk is going to be really too hot. So you're going to scald it. The weird thing is you can actually smell the milk when you scald it. When it gets above about 165 degrees, it kind of has this sickening sweet smell to it. So you don't want to do that. So that's basically how you use the thermometer. One of the other things that's really important when you're steaming your milk, there's some things that you should always be aware of. Like we said, cold milk, cold pitcher. Never fill your pitcher more than half full with milk, because a lot of times you're going to angle the pitcher in order to get the milk circulating the right way, so you don't want it spilling over the tops. It makes a heck of a mess. The second thing is the milk is going to increase in volume, particularly if you're steaming cappuccino milk, so you don't want it to go over the top. Now what we're going to do is we're going to find our W spot. Now that is the point in the milk pitcher where I'm confident I can set my steam tip inside the milk, inside the pitcher, and when I fully turn on the steam wand, I know that I'm going to get the milk spinning like a whirlpool. So let's just, you know what, we're going to try it right now. There we go. In a whirlpool. Now, if I was to make latte milk, what I want to do is I want to keep that milk spinning in the pitcher. I'm just going to lower it a little bit. What you want to be thinking about is keeping the steam tip in position in relatively the same position in the milk. So basically, you're just going to lower it a little bit at a time because you're going to increase the volume. If I'm making cappuccino milk, I'm going to lower it quite a bit more. I'm just going to keep lowering, and I'm going to make sure that my milk volume is increasing the pitcher. I get nice foam with no bubbles that kind of looks like meringue. I'm going to do some bad steaming. So this would be what would be the ugly part of steaming. So again, the good, bad, and ugly of steaming. What I'm going to do is I'm going to try to mimic, which is hard for me to do, the let's call it irresponsible milk steaming habits that you don't want to pick up. Okay. First of all, we're going to turn it on. If you hear that sound when you're at home, stop. Basically what you're doing is the milk is not being spun around. You have the steam wand too close to the bottom or the side of the pitcher, or the milk is way too hot. The next one is kind of the opposite of the steam tip being too close to the bottom, too close to the top. This one is I'm going to have my steam tip too far above the milk, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to get like big bubbles. Okay, again, if you hear that sound, it's terrible. As you can tell, we're getting bubbles, certainly not microfoam. And the other thing is the milk's not circulating properly. God, I'm so tempted to go down and fix it, but I won't, okay? There. So, if your milk looks like that, it's not good. All full of big bubbles, it's just not good. If you steam your milk incorrectly, you can kind of tell by the way it pours out. You want it to be the same consistency all the way through. You can see it's very thin. See how the milk is kind of separated from the foam? All right. Now, if you let your milk sit for too long, the milk's going to separate. This is the pitcher I just steamed, and what I want to show you is how nice the foam is on that. And actually, like with any milk, you want to kind of have a nice meringue-like finish just like that. And I think through practice and being confident, I think you'll get very good at steaming milk. Again, this is Mark Jackson. I'm so glad you had time to spend with us and have a great day.